May 1st, that's the day that Uber and Lyft said they're out of Minneapolis and gone from MSP if the city council's decision from last week to boost wages stands. But the Star Tribune reports that Uber is already getting a head start by shutting down their only Twin Cities service center. In less than a month, Richfield's Greenlight Hub will be no more. And that means no face-to-face place for drivers trying to get their cars fixed or inspected or anything else that comes up driving those cars. But if you think that means they're as good as gone, we got another sign today that there is still a whole lot more drama that's likely going to play out between now and then. Minneapolis City Council member Andrea Jenkins, former president of the council, who voted for this ordinance from day one and reinforced her decision by overriding the mayor's veto, is now reconsidering that decision in a very public way. If you're wondering what prompted this sudden change and what, if anything, it means, yeah, us too. So Kent tried to get some answers today.
Yeah, tried is the operative word here, Jana. Councilmember Jenkins hasn't been responding to our questions today, but we do know she is reconsidering this ordinance because she did that very formally this morning. According to the latest city council agenda, Jenkins is giving notice of intent to move reconsideration of the rideshare ordinance. If you're wondering what that means, it's a formal step to force the council to vote on this again in 3 weeks. As of now, there is no sign that the council will vote any differently. It would take votes from 7 members to change course. And I didn't hear from anyone willing to change their vote today. That includes, again, Councilmember Jenkins, who simply didn't respond to my questions. I did speak to Councilmember Linnea Palmisano about this effort, though. She says it stems from discussions she had with Jenkins for the past week.
I really appreciate that Councilmember Jenkins saw an opportunity to try and continue the conversation for a few weeks.
Did Councilmember Jenkins tell you what prompted this? We tried to ask her and we're not getting any response today.
I can't speak for Councilmember Jenkins. I'll say that I think all of us at City Hall have gotten overwhelming amounts of feedback about this, even in the last week.
While much of that came from individuals and families who depend on rideshare services, Palmisano says they also heard from several medical providers who have patients who depend on rides to get to appointments, expressing concerns, she says, about the void that might be left if the ordinance stands.
That vote was 10-3. This motion would require 7 votes in order to even reconsider. Do you believe that there are votes there to make any of this happen?
I'm always hopeful. I'm not... confident that there are. I do think 3 weeks of conversation with the state would really help us.
Keep in mind, though, even if the council has the votes to reconsider this ordinance, they also have to come to consensus on what that means. Palmisano told me she would prefer to scrap it altogether and let the state determine rates for Uber and Lyft drivers. Others, including Mayor Fry, have expressed support for a middle ground somewhere between the city and the state's recent recommendations on wages and rates, Jana. So that's where we stand today.
Good times. And we should note the mayor's out of town this week, so we didn't talk to him, tried to talk to the council member. And when we heard from state lawmakers yesterday, so this is like a big mess churning in a lot of different directions.
Yeah, a lot of things at talk and at play in the legislature. Again, this motion was made for tomorrow's meeting, so maybe we'll hear from Jenkins tomorrow, but they don't have to vote on it. It's just a formality. It goes on to that April 11th agenda when they actually vote.
All right, hurry up and wait. Thank you so much, Kent Erdahl. Yeah.